Line L1 and L2 are perpendicular to each other and their slopes are m1 and m2 respectively. Which of the following is the possible value of m1 minus m2? We have to find out the possible value of m1 minus m2 while we already know the relationship between the two perpendicular lines is given by m1 multiplied by m2 is equal to minus 1. So from this we can find out that m2 is equal to minus 1 over m1. I'm going to substitute this here and this expression becomes m1 minus minus 1 over m1, and its value we have to find out. That means this expression becomes n1 plus 1 over m1. Now we have to understand that what values can this expression assume. Now let's quickly understand this thing from one of the algebraic expressions. Suppose we have an expression x plus 1 over x, where x is any positive number. Then what values can x plus 1 over x assume? Then we can just start some of the values. For example, if we substitute x equal to 1 by 2, x plus 1 over x, value becomes 1 over 2 plus 1 over 1 over 2, which is equal to 2.5. If we substitute x equal to 1, then x plus 1 upon x becomes 2. If we substitute x equal to 1.5, then the value of x plus 1 over x becomes, that is 2, that is 1.5 plus 1 over 1.5. 1 over 1.5 is same as 2 over 3, which is value 0.66. That means 2.16. Now if you keep iterating the values, we will notice one thing, that the value of x plus 1 upon x when x is positive cannot be less than 2. So now that we do this experiment, we understand that x plus 1 upon x definitely has to be greater than or equal to 2. And similarly, for the negative values, if we see x plus 1 upon x, then the value of x plus 1 upon x will always be less than or equal to minus 2. Now these are two really critical observations for us, because they are going to help us answer this question. So we have, and such questions have already been appeared in GMAT basing on this kind of algebraic expression. So we can understand that m1 plus 1 upon m1 will either be greater than or equal to 2, or it will be less than or equal to minus 2. That means m1 plus 1 upon m1 cannot assume any value between minus 2 and plus 2. So any value between minus 2 and plus 2 can straight away be ruled out. So A option is between minus 2 and plus 2, B option as well, C option is not, D option is between minus 2 and plus 2, E option as well. So we are left with only one option, that is C, and C option becomes our answer. So the key takeaway in this question was first to use the property of two perpendicular lines, apply them here, and then understand the range of the values of this algebraic expression. I hope you enjoyed the learning. Thank you so much.